Welcome to Unreal Tips and Tricks. In this presentation, we're going to be looking at the Sun Position Calculator plugin and how we can animate it in runtime with the help of a slider. To begin, make sure the plugin's loaded by going to the top menu bar and clicking on Settings and opening the plugin browser. In the plugin browser, click on Built-in and then search for Sun. If the Sun Position Calculator has not been enabled, turn it on and restart your engine. Once the engine's opened back up, go to the content browser and click on the view options in the lower right-hand corner. Make sure that show plugins content is turned on, as well as show engine content. So with the view options now correctly set, click the folder icon in the content browser to bring up the search folders command. In search folders, type Sun to quickly jump to the Sun Position content folder. In the Sun Position content folder, you'll see that we have a new asset that was made for us when we enabled the Sun Position calculator. Drag and drop this blueprint into your level, and as soon as we do that, the blueprint is now driving my Sun Sky system. I have a nice gizmo that allows me to see where north is, and what we want to do is we want to make it slightly later in the year so the sun starts to flip around to the other side of the buildings. And as I increase the months, it not only updates the directional light, but it also updates the sky sphere. So now that we've done that, go ahead and click the back arrow button in the content browser to get ourselves back to our content folder. So now that we have the Sun Position blueprint in our scene working, the next step is to generate our user interface. In the content browser, click on Add New and go into the user interface folder. Select the widget blueprint to create it. With the widget blueprint made, go ahead and give it a name and double click on the widget blueprint to bring up the designer. So in the widget designer, we're going to go ahead and add a slider by just dragging it out from the palette. And I'm going to make this slider slightly larger. So now that we have our user interface designed, we're going to jump over to the graph and start talking about the blueprint code that we need to generate to have that slider ultimately drive the BP Sun Position. Now the BP Sun Position is obviously a blueprint, and to update any of those attributes on that blueprint in runtime, we need to create an object reference of that data. So this is very easy to do inside of Unreal using the getAllActors class. So what we're going to do is start off with the event script and just drag out and do a search for getAllActors of class. So just type getAllActors of class. And now that we've done that, we can specify the class that we want to get, which is going to be the BP Sun Position. So just come down here and just start searching for Sun, and we'll grab the BP Sun Position. So what this is this is going to be an array of information. We want to get a copy of that information. So all we have to do is drag out of the actor and just start to type get, and we're going to do get a copy. And that copy is, again, an array of information at the first index. So now that we've done that, the next thing that we want to do is we actually want to store this information in a variable. The reason we want to do that is because getAllActors of class can become costly. So all we're going to do is we're going to drag out and we're going to say promote to variable. So as soon as we promote that to the variable, we're going to connect these guys together. We're going to want to give that variable a name. And you'll notice that as we come over here and look at the variable type, its variable type is BP Sun Position. So that's why we're going to be able to work with and manipulate that data. It's exactly the same as the actor class, which makes perfect sense. So what we want to do is give this variable a meaningful name. And what it ends up being is it's actually the BP Sun Position actor. So we'll just say BP Sun Actor. Awesome. So now we have that information stored in a way that we can work with it and we can modify it and we can use it in Blueprint, which is exactly what we had to do. So let's go ahead and slide this up here and talk about the next chunk of code that we want to build. This is going to be the code that we're going to use to hook that slider up to and update the sun. Very, very cool. So what we're going to do is we're going to drag out the BP Sun Position actor, and we're going to tell it that we want to get the information from that. So we've now got our information here. We're going to use this to do a couple of things. We're going to drag out and we're going to tell it that we want to update the sun. So just start searching for update and click down on update sun.
We also want to use this to set one of the time variables on the BP Sun Position. So in this example, I'm going to use hours. I'll just drag a wire out and search for hours and then select set hours.
And ultimately, we want to have that set hours drive the update of the sun. So we're just going to hook those guys together. We'll kind of clean these nodes up a little bit. So now that we've done that, the next thing that we want to do is we want to have something drive the hours. Now, we've obviously made a slider. That's the ideal candidate to drive the hours. So how do you do that? Well, if you highlight the slider variable, you'll notice that we can create events. And what we want to do is we want to have an event that's created on value change. So all I have to do is click the plus icon on value change, and it creates a new event node for me on value change. And this is going to ultimately drive the set hour. So we're going to link those two guys together. And what I want to do is the sliders go from a range of 0 to 1. We don't really want to have a 0 to 1 slider because we want those hours to move through the morning to night. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull out of the value and we're going to remap that range by searching for map and doing a mapped clamped range. So again, let's just kind of clean this stuff up a little bit. So we're going to go from 0 to 1 and we're going to switch that over to be something like 7 in the morning to 20 hours at night. So now we'll just take this value and we'll have that drive the sun, and pretty straightforward there. So we can kind of zoom out here. So we've now got everything built the way we want. Let's go ahead and hit compile and save. So our first chunk of blueprint code is creating the object reference. Our second chunk of blueprint code is taking that object reference and using it to update the sun and the slider to basically update the hours. So it's pretty straightforward. So now that we've done this, the final thing that we need to do is get that user interface, this widget blueprint user interface, to display on our level when we hit play. And there's a few ways of doing this. The way that I like to do it is to actually add another blueprint into my scene and have that generate the actual UI. So how do you do that? So if you right click inside the content folder and click on blueprint class, we're just going to create a simple actor blueprint, and we're going to call this, something meaningful like blueprint_UI_maker. So we've got our blueprint UI maker. Let's jump in there and add a few nodes into this guy. So in the event graph, what we want to do is on the event play, we want to generate a piece of UI. So we're going to go over here and we're going to say create. So we're going to create the widget. And the widget that we want to create is going to be this widget sun position slider that we've already made. And all we have to do now is add this to the viewport. So drag out and type add. Pretty straightforward. Jump up to add to viewport and just tidy this stuff up. So that looks pretty good. So now we can go ahead and compile that guy and save it. So we now have our BP UI maker that we could drag and drop into any level in our project. And it's going to give us the ability to drive that sun position. So let's go ahead and drag and drop it into this level. And with that done, we can go and hit play and check out how our slider works with the BP sun position. So here we are in our scene. And obviously if I start to grab this slider, you can see as I move through the hours of the day, that sun updates, and notice the background sky also updates. So it's just a really, really cool tool, and it allows us to do some really, really fun stuff. So as I swipe through the daytime here, we can get this really nice light study happening in our environment. So that's just a really quick example of how we can build a UI system that gives us the ability to update attributes on blueprints in runtime using the sun position calculator plugin. Hope you guys enjoyed that. Cheers, everybody.